What's up, you guys? Welcome back to Why Body Nation. I'm about to do a night drop of my 2022 Dodge Charger Hellcat Red Eye. I'm going to show you everything I'm going to be putting on here, activating with my theft deterrent stuff, theft deterrent measures, so that you guys can see, you know, how I can drop my car off pretty confidently at night, even though everybody knows Dodge dealerships are prime targets for thieves.
An A-Rob car dealership is out more than $1 million after an overnight burglary.
This story is incredible, and the investigation continues as police and the FBI work to locate six missing luxury vehicles.
I spoke to the owner of this dealership, and he tells me that it's been quite a process getting things back up and running. Not only did the group drive eight vehicles off of this lot, six of which haven't been found yet, but they also stole more than 300 keys. Technicians and locksmiths are still working to replace and reprogram the keys belonging to these vehicles. The break-in happened just after midnight on Sunday, according to A-Rab police. The thieves threw a rock through a window in the dealership service bay. Once inside, they turned off and wiped several hours worth of surveillance video. The dealership owner told me they then plugged a computer into the dealership's key safe, unlocked it, and took all the keys. When police were notified the next morning of the break-in, they found several trucks and cars missing. A-Rab Police Chief Shane Washburn says his department is working to identify who committed this crime. The dealership estimates this crime resulted in a loss of about $1.2 million. Chief Washburn says this burglary looks a lot like several others that have recently taken place across the region, and his department has brought the FBI into their investigation.
So, not going to tell you what dealership it is. You guys could probably guess, but obviously you're going to be seeing this after the fact, so that's not a big deal. But with that being said, let's get into it.
So first thing is something that I always have on my car, no matter, you know, if I'm doing something sketchy or not, is my Destroyer1320.com. Boom, boom. Neutral strap cover right here. That's always installed. That's usually a red pull lever. They can put your car in a neutral. They don't need keys or nothing. They can just break in and put your car in a neutral. You know, get that at Destroyer1320.com. Obviously, we stand behind that product. Nice, thick steel, tamper-proof screws, good to go. I'll talk about this in a second. I'm going to talk about some more techie things. So, before we go any farther, don't sleep on valet mode. I'll get to that later, but you guys always forget about valet mode, I feel like. We'll get to it. Next thing, kill switch, TrackHawk GPS kill switch. I'll put a screen grab in here of how it operates, but
to use the kill switch, simply open the TrackHawk GPS app, send the command, and now I have the key right here, foot on the brake, nothing. So even if someone had your key, they could not steal your car. But let's say it's you and you want to drive the car, simply go back into the app, disable the kill switch. It's that quick. You see green and you're good to go.
It's a kill switch and it's a tracker and it's all operated through your phone. So even if they've got a key programmer, sucks to suck, they're not going to be able to get your car started because it has nothing to do with the key. Even if the thief had the key or programmed a key, kill switch. So we've got Destroyer 1320, TrackHawk GPS kill switch. I also have a steering wheel lock right here. These are obviously not a primary theft deterrent mechanism. This is just something to, a little icing on the cake, a little F you to the thieves. I have seen thieves cut through steering wheels before, so do not rely on this as one or maybe one of two things. This is definitely like your fifth, sixth, seventh theft deterrent measure. Just something to piss the thieves off long enough to distract them from all your other stuff. Next, valet mode. So, for valet mode, obviously you just go into SRT, you do drive modes, and then you can go into valet mode, and then yes, and then obviously 6969. And now the car is doing all those things. So, even if they were able to start your car, then they would be stuck in valet mode where they have like, I don't know, 10 horsepower. The car is pretty nerf. Like, you can't really do too much to it. I'll even drive over to the dealership in valet mode, but it's enough to get the car in and out of valets, in and out of garages like the dealership. But don't sleep on valet mode, guys. That is factory to the car. Dodge is trying to help you out at least a little bit. I know I shit on Dodge a lot, but at least they have valet mode. All right, next. So you guys see I have the direct connection tuner right here, but it is not on right now. I haven't even taken the screen protector off yet. Ooh, a little ASMR there. The reason that it's not running right now is because that plugs into the OBD2 port. Right now, I have my OBD2 splitter plugged in that has my car lock, OBD2 tracker and alarm, and I have the Mopar EVTS connected, and both of those are plumbed up into the dash so that, yeah, they could unplug it, but if they did that, I get this super annoying siren on my phone, like way louder than an iPhone alarm.
So we'll unplug that. We will go ahead and plug in the extender right here. There you go, you guys heard it. It just is alarming my phone. So their app is not bad.
And that lets me know that someone is messing with the car. So again, car lock, is that something that should be your only theft deterrent mechanism? Absolutely not. Mopar EVTS, same thing. But now you guys can tell, I have the Uconnect that comes with this car, which is garbage. I have car lock, which is decent. I have Mopar EVTS, which is decent. And then I have Trackhawk GPS kill switch. And that kill switch is the money right there. And it comes with GPS, real-time tracking, speed alerts, geofence alerts. I have a geofence set up around the dealership right here. So among all the other notifications I would get with car lock blowing up my phone, Trackhawk GPS would let me know that the car had been moved as well. And Mopar EVTS would let me know as well. So my phone will explode if anyone is moving this car without my knowledge. All right, so we've got our Mopar EVTS over here. We've got car lock over here. We've got valet mode. We've got Destroyer 1320. And we've got Trackhawk GPS, which is also on the phone. We've got the, what's it called? Beep, boop, bop, boop. Steering wheel lock, which is just kind of, like we said, icing on the cake. And we have the taser, which is activated in your audio settings. Taser is one of those things where kind of tough to use the taser when you're dropping it off at the dealership, because it's one of those things where if the dealership doesn't know how to use it and doesn't know how to put your pin in here, that could mess up the car. That could kill the car for an hour or longer. So I wouldn't necessarily recommend using your taser if you have one that is using these steering wheel controls to do the pin lock feature. That's the main feature I am talking about here. My car also has an AirTag or two stashed in it somewhere. So that is, again, that's kind of like this. Definitely not your top theft deterrent mechanism, but all else fails, there's an AirTag following the thief around in your car. So with that being said, y'all, again, quick video, but I just listed off like 7 or 8 things that should take your car from really easy to steal when it comes stock to damn near impossible to steal. And if they get it, they are getting tracked like a hawk with Trackhawk GPS, with all your additional GPS, you know, car lock, Mopar EVTS, Uconnect, all that stuff. And yeah, you guys could go get CompuStar, you could go get Viper, you could go get all that stuff. All I'm saying is you got to mix them together. Just like you would do tint and wrap and wheels. Like, you're not just going to get tint and be like, yeah, my car is sick. Like, most of you guys are going to get a lot of things like that. Theft deterrent's the same way. Stack everything together. Personally, my top two are Destroyer 1320 and Trackhawk GPS. Use code WBN on Destroyer1320.com, saves you 20%. And code WBN10 saves you 10% on TrackhawkGPS.com for that GPS kill switch, that 2-in-1. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. Do you think I'm being super sketchy by dropping this thing off at night for probably going to sit for 7-8 hours before the dealership employees show up? Am I rolling the dice? I mean, I guess I'll have a follow-up video on this so you guys will know whether or not the car was either broken into or even stolen, but I bet you it's not going to get stolen. Knock on carbon fiber. Thanks for tuning in, y'all. Protect your cars. Stay safe out there, and I will see you guys for the next video.
right, everybody, here's our latest product. You saw the video where they're taking a picture of the VIN code and making a key? Not today. Ain't happening. Store at 1320.com. Go get you one. It's called a VIN cover.